Alright folks, today I'm gonna show you the Lomo al Trapo beer and pork version. It's time to grill! This video has a story, and the story is about a video I did almost 1 year ago or so. That was the Lomo al Trapo, a Colombian dish, a Colombian traditional idea of cooking a beef tenderloin in a salt crust in a towel that is soaked in red wine. And I made that and it failed. And you might have seen that, and a lot of people on my social media sites complained about that. It was really fun to read that because it has an amazing reach. I guess about 1 million people saw that video on Facebook or so. But I decided to show that I'm able and capable of creating this in a different way and better. So I decided to do a version with beer instead of red wine and pork instead of beef. All you have to do is to separate the egg white from the egg yolk from 3 eggs and mix that together with 1 kilo of salt. This is basic salt. It's kind of funny how the people at the cash desk due to Corona react when you want to buy 2 packages of salt. This is a bottle of beer. I used German beer. And this is a pork tenderloin. This pork tenderloin is from my favorite online butchery, oberpfalzbeef.de. Of course, I will put the link into the video description so you can check out the products and prices here in Germany. Might be interesting for you wherever you come from. Now we clean that pork loin a little bit, cut away the silver skin and things we won't want there. And all in all, this one is pretty good. There's not very much that we have to cut away. Sometimes grilling a pork loin is difficult because there's one thicker part and one that is thinner, and so we have to cut it like here a little bit and then fold it over so we have more or less the same thickness over the whole tenderloin. That's exactly what we are looking for. Now we take a glass bowl and an old cotton kitchen towel. Make sure not to use a good one because you won't be able to use this afterwards. Then put in some beer and let it soak up the beer. If you have the feeling it's not wet enough, just add some more beer and let that soak up the beer. If you have the feeling it's too wet, give it a small press, just like that, and throw away the rest. That's exactly what we're looking for. Of course, you don't need the bowl while grilling, but I like this one, which is perfect for preparing this dish. It's from IKEA. Do you have IKEA wherever you are? I guess you have. The first mistake I made when I made the first Lomo al Trapo version was the salt. Dough was, the salt crust was not thick enough. And of course there was no egg white in it. It was only salt. I wonder why this works with the other YouTube guys that made the video. I guess they're cheating. So, due to the fact that we used the egg white mixture, this one will get a solid salt crust. Now take the pork loin and place it like so. And now roll it. Make sure to have an equal salt crust almost everywhere. So roll it, roll it, roll it, press down, and now open it again and see if it worked. Almost. Of course, save some to fix that. Make sure also to put enough salt crust at the side. The pork loin should be covered in that salt crust completely. Now again, close it, press down gently and roll it. And now you can feel with your fingers if you have your salt crust everywhere. Make sure also to close the ends with the cotton towel now. But that's the good thing with that bowl, it works more or less alone. Yeah, close it and keep rolling. You will now have a tightly rolled towel with a salt crust and a pork tenderloin in the center. Now take it out, and then we have to close it. Looks really good so far. Now close it. Of course, you know how to do that. I won't bother you too long. I will speed this up a little bit for you. And after three or four with that strings, you're done. In the meantime, I have already prepared a star coal chimney with a mixture of charcoal and briquettes. And the second big mistake I had in the first video was my charcoal and my grill was far too hot. It burned completely before it could make any crust or whatever. So now take the mixture, place it, make sure to have enough space and flatten down, and then wait for 10 minutes until it cooled down a little bit. Now place your package on that charcoal and let it grill or cook there for 3 to 4 minutes. I speed this up a little bit for you, and you can now see the heat coming up, but it's not burning. That's because of the beer. And what it also makes, the heat makes the salt like a rock. It's completely solid and it has a complete salt crust over the whole area where the heat is. After 3 or 4 minutes, just give it a turn. And you will now see that a little bit is still on there. You can take that off. But the salt crust is still completely seared and safe and strong. Now 3 or 4 minutes from the other side. Same thing here. And then it's the plan to put it, let it rest in the grill, but not on the direct charcoal. Yeah, place it on the right side while the coal stays on the left side. Close the lid for another 4 or 5 minutes, and then I will leave you with the original sound to see how good that salt crust worked. Man, this looks incredible. Here's the result. This is a pork loin and it's still a little bit white. So we put this on our infrared part of my Landman grill just to give it a little bit of color from the outside. Make sure not to cook it too long. It already has cooked a little bit too long. I have to confess that this one is a little bit overdone for pork loin. I would usually grill my pork loin with a little pink in the center. This is not possible here, but the result is stunning because the taste of the pork is really intense. So you will get the full flavor of a pork loin, and this is due to the salt crust. Of course, I will put a link for the Lomo al Trappo, the red wine version, at the end of the video, so you can check it out then. Now take it off, and then we cut and see how it looks like. And of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Yeah. Really, really good. I'm really happy with the result. Here's how it looks like in the center. Just add some Jack and Smoke seasoning. And of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Yeah, I would really appreciate reading your comments and your opinion about that recipe idea and the technique. Make sure to watch the other video. Make sure to check my Facebook channel for all the haters. Make sure to subscribe. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.